It's time for The Mix at 6. Counting down the top hip-hop and R&B songs in the country. The Mix 88.9. Lynchburg's number one station for hip-hop and R&B. Soul and reggae.
Shock the system.
Kane is in the building.
For life.
Yeard, what's up, y'all? I hope everyone is well. I know that we got some snow and a lot of people went without power, so hopefully you got your power back. Hopefully, everyone is well and safe and warm and staying out of this snow, because it is a lot and it is everywhere. And from what I hear, there's more coming. I don't know how that's going to affect my plans for this weekend, but we will see. But, you know, we got to get into all of that right now. Welcome to the Mix at 6. Welcome to this palace of positivity that we have cultivated, known as Vibe Club. You are here at the Mix 88.9 for another stellar show. For the next hour, I will be bringing you the top 6 hip-hop hits in the nation with my randomness sprinkled in between. And we all know how much I love to talk and how much you love to listen. So we're going to put those two talents together and we're going to have a great time. I'm going to talk about a few things today. I meant to talk about something yesterday, but I ran out of time, but I will get to it today, and that be Antonio Brown. I definitely have some takes as far as that goes, and as far as what he did, as far as my view on it. But as always, welcome. If you're returning, thank you for coming back. If you're new here, I hope you enjoy yourself. Just know that your opinion is all also welcome, that we respect all views here, that everyone, this is a safe space for you to come and express your thoughts, for you to come and listen to someone who is not judging you, who is not looking down on you, who wants nothing but positive things for you. That's the whole reason that we're here. And even if we don't agree on something, that's cool. We can agree to disagree, but we're going to love each other regardless, because that's what we foster here. We foster positivity. We foster being together as a people. Doesn't matter what your color is. Doesn't matter what your sexuality is. Doesn't matter. None of that matters. All that matters is you come here with a good attitude. You have a good time. I have a good time. And that's what I'm here for. That's the goal. But let me go ahead and get into the first topic, which is, of course, Antonio Brown. Now, like I said, I meant to get into it yesterday, but I just ran out of time. I was talking so much about me. I got wrapped up in me and what I was doing and how my break went that I didn't have a chance to get to it. And that's on me. But I'm going to get to it today. So, during the football game between the Jets and the Buccaneers the other day over in East Rutherford, New Jersey, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers taking on the Jets, as I stated. During the third quarter, Antonio Brown seemed to be a little frustrated on the sideline. So what he decided to do was take his shoulder pads and gear off, to take his Under Armour shirt off and gloves off and throw them into the stands and walk off the field. The team was actually playing at the other end of the field. He walked to the other end of the field, walked through the end zone. He was like waving and hyping the crowd up, gave the peace sign and ran off the field. Now, a lot of people are attributing this to Antonio Brown being crazy. A lot of people are attributing this to a lot of things because he has indeed been troubled. He's gone through a lot and has done a lot. A lot of it's self-inflicted. A lot of the criticism he get is because of things that he's done. He's had a fake vaccination card. Like he's done a couple of things. Like, so this is not something that I'm like crazy surprised about. But Apparently, two of his teammates, Mike Evans and OJ Howard, tried to calm him down on the sideline before he took his stuff off. But they couldn't get him to calm down, and he ended up doing what he did, and he left. So apparently, he left the stadium, jumped in an Uber, went to the studio, and dropped the song. That's what he did. He went and dropped the song, and then he was later spotted at the Nets game, courtside. So now we can all sit here and have our opinions about it. I have my opinion, but it's just that. It's just an opinion. My opinion is that he is an individual who is crying out for help, who needs help, but he will not get it unless he wants it. You can't help someone who doesn't want to be helped. He is also an adult. He's also a grown man. So any decisions he makes, he has to live with those decisions. And if his bank account can support his antics, there's nothing that we can really say about it. He didn't hurt anybody. He's not hurting anybody. He didn't hurt anybody. He just took his stuff off and left. He didn't get in a fight. He didn't, you know, swing on nobody. He seems to be having a good time. Like I said, dropped the song, and then he went to a basketball game. So if he's happy, then I don't know what else more we can say about it. You know, you can say he's dumb for doing this or dumb for doing that, but whatever works for him, whatever works for you in your personal life, you ain't got to do what everybody else expects you to do. I don't support the whole leaving your team hanging thing because, you know, I'm a huge football fan. But that's just my opinion. I am not, you know, he's not hurting me financially. He's not, you know, taking away from me or what I'm doing. So is nothing that anybody can really say about it. Everybody can talk about it and say how they feel about it. But at the end of the day, he got to deal with that. And if he's happy with what he did, and if this is the mental health break that he needed, and this helps him get his mental together, I support it. I can't be mad at him. I really can't. The only thing that I disagree with is leaving his team hanging. They could have did it after the game, especially leaving Tom Brady hanging. Tom Brady has went out on a limb for him more than one occasion, moved him into his house, has spoken up for the guy, put his neck out for him. Now, Tom is still defending him. So Tom is still saying, you know, he needs love, he needs support, he doesn't need to be, you know, ridiculed and judged. So Tom is close to the situation. Tom knows more about it than we all do, you know, except for Antonio Brown. So I would go ahead and trust Tom on this one and say that, you know, we just got to support him. He's not hurting anybody. He just didn't want to play football anymore. He didn't want to play football anymore. And you can't fault somebody for making a decision based off what's making them happy. The only parallel that I can make to it personally is when I decided to get out of the military. All I heard was, it's stupid, don't get out of the military, why are you doing that? Why, you know, it's this and it's that. But that's easy for someone to say on the outside looking in. People didn't know what I was actually going through while I was in there. People only assumed and people only thought they knew what was going on while I was in there. I was in hell. I was in hell mentally. I was in hell, like spiritually. Like I was in a bad way. Like mentally, I was in a bad way. I really was. And I wasn't getting the help that I needed. And I, you know, and the most dangerous part is I didn't think I needed help while I was in there. I thought I was invincible. I thought I couldn't be touched. Like, sometimes you have to make those decisions and step away. You have to make those choices and get away and do what's best for you. That's why I always say we can't live this life based off of what someone else is saying. We can't live this life based off what someone else expects of us. We have to live this life based off what's best for us and what's best for our long-term health. Mental health is the most important thing that I'm glad is being shoved to the forefront right now. And I am all about being who you are, being true to who you are, and I support anyone who lives their truth and does things for them, for them, because you only live this life one time. We only get to do it one time. So you can take opinions. It's nothing wrong with taking advice. It's nothing wrong with hearing people's opinions, because, you know, some people might have good opinions. Some people might have good ideas that may shape what you decide to do. But you should never, never, never live your life based off of what others think of you, of what others are gonna think of you. So always do what's best for you. That's why, you know, it took me a couple of days to digest this whole thing, and it's real easy to just pile on Antonio Brown. It's real easy to just jump on the bandwagon and say this, that, and the third about him. But at the end of the day, he's doing what his bank account and his pockets can handle. He's doing what's best for him. He's doing what makes him happy. And, you know, you can't be upset about that. You can't be mad about that. So I salute him. I just hope everything is okay. I just hope if he needs help, he gets the help that he needs. And I hope that, you know, all the success following his decisions. Because from what I hear, there may be some teams that want him. There may be some other clubs that he may be playing football for. So you may not have seen the end or the last of Antonio Brown on the football field. But moving on, Andy Cohen, he was on CNN for the New Year's Eve bash, and he's facing some backlash for some comments that he made about the outgoing mayor, Mayor de Blasio. And here's what he had to say.
Tell us something, Andy.
Watching Mayor de Blasio.
Oh, don't go on a rant.
Do his.
Don't go on a rant.
Victory lap dance. Don't. After 4 years of the crappiest term as the mayor of New York, the only thing that Democrats and Republicans can agree on is what a horrible mayor he has been. Wow. So, sayonara, sucka.
Now, he was facing so much backlash. In fact, it was rumors that he wasn't going to be invited back for next year's New Year's Eve bash, but a spokesperson from CNN has said that Andy has been, they have discussed it, and it won't happen again, but he will be invited back next year. Now, Andy did say he had one regret as far as some of the things that he said, because he said more than what was in that audio. But here's what he had to say as far as his only regret goes.
The only thing that I regret, that I slammed the ABC broadcast, and I really like Ryan Seacrest, and he's a great guy, and I really regret saying that, and I was just stupid and drunk and feeling it, and I was continuing the journey rant, and I just kept talking, and I shouldn't have, and I felt bad about that.
Me personally, I don't think it's a big deal. Everybody was drinking. Everybody was having a good time. He ain't say nothing crazy. He didn't offend nobody. Whatever. Stop being so sensitive about everything. If from what I understand, the mayor really wasn't doing a good job, so he didn't say anything wrong to begin with. So just because you don't want to hear it doesn't mean that he was wrong. So, you know, it is what it is. I'm glad he'll be back next year, because him and Anderson Cooper are entertaining. Now, most of you know, but for those who don't know, Common and Tiffany Haddish were dating at one point, and they actually broke up, which was really sad, because they got together during the quarantine. And based on what Common said, it was because they got back to work and really didn't have time for each other, so he ended up parting ways. Here's actually what he had to say about their relationship with Tiffany Haddish.
We had a real healthy and loving, like, it probably was the most mature relationship I have been in a relationship, meaning the communication, the respect. A lot of relationships that I honestly have been in, I've been on the move because, you know, it's just me and that person we both have professions. Well, I think once Tiffany and I got back on the move, it really didn't allow for us to spend as much time and put as much energy into our relationship.
Now, Tiffany was actually on Hollywood Unlocked, and she responded to hearing what he had to say as far as the breakup goes, and she had something very interesting to say.
I was disappointed. I was very disappointed. I was like, oh, okay, because that's not what you told me, but okay.
Wait, well, what did he tell you?
Damn, you know what? That's between us.
And do you feel like at this point you're done with, like, famous guys? Would you date another famous man?
I would one.
So I'm assuming there's a reason why he told one side of the story, or told what he wanted people to know, and that's his right. That's their business. So he don't have to explain why he did what he did or give any details of their relationship. And I'm not sitting here making that assumption, not assumption, or making that claim that he owes us an explanation, because he doesn't. It's not our business. It's his relationship. It's their relationship. It's their business. So, like she says, you don't keep it between them. So they know what the truth is. And, you know, as long as he's happy and she's happy, that's all that's really important. That's all that really matters. So the rest of it is just white noise. But anyway, you ain't here to hear about breakups, are you? You here to hear, H-E-R-E, to hear, H-E-A-R, good music. And I got that for you. Matter of fact, I got the top 6 hip-hop hits in the nation. So let's go ahead and get into number 6. Here is Chris Brown and Young Thug featuring Future, Lil Durk, and Mulatto. Go Crazy Remix. Here on The Mix at 6 on The Mix 88.9.
Give me the hip-hop countdown. Yo. Number 6.
You living life, but you ain't working though. Her man said that way long, I'm the first to know. She in control, she want a Birkin, get a Birkin though.
Go crazy, do the challenge, show me lie now.
Can't allow 100, waving her on clubhouse. Off the 42 on my dog, I feel like Doug now. I done sipped so much, I think I'm blood now. I'm from the trenches, for sure, for sure. You got my back, let me know And Post Oaks hold me close Rose truck hit the button just to close the door, yeah.
You on a flight, you know that a like me can change your life, oh baby. Everything you do is amazing. Ain't nobody got to go crazy. I got what you need. Everybody think you shy, but I know you a freak, little baby. Everything you do is amazing. Ain't nobody got to go crazy. I got what you need. Everybody think you shy, but I know you a freak, little baby.
I let him hit it once, he went brazy. The round and left is all laid. Gucci and proud of me, if you proud of me. Give me brain like psychology. Big Lotto, he tryna hit the lottery. Wrist in my necklace, on chill, Netflix. I ain't still no other, cause he got the best. And I got that way. He know not to test this. If I leave him, he'll be looking for me in his next. Thought baby, I go crazy. He put me in that Corvette, that why the pay me? Yeah. They a pin, cause we grown. Turn a one night stand to a happy home.
Trips deep crib in the middle of the night. I know that you miss me cause I put it down right. Damn, babe, I can put you on a flight. You know that a like me can change your life, oh baby. Everything you do is amazing. Ain't nobody got you go crazy.
I got what you need.
I got what you need. Everybody think you shy, but I know you a freak, love, baby.
I cheat on you, you cheat on me. You ain't loyal. They think you're shy, but you're a freak. That's why I spoil you. I could've hit it for the free. Christian Dior, I'm sweeping you out for your feet in a spaceship. I come through, go swimming in the middle of the night. We trending worldwide, good baby, we'll vibe. Had a with a Muslim and a Christian. I swapped out religions. Felt like Jesus Christ when I did it. Have you ever went skinny dipping on a flight? PJ came with a bag full of ice. Oh, babe, I could change up your life. Solitaire is whiter than rice, going crazy.
I could've whispered to this on this remix. She just came out of twat, I can see it. Like the pussy, the enemy every time, gotta kill it. Trying to live against love in the mirror. Break it back, Kelly got you flyed in a kite. Rich, she made a virgin twice. Don't block none of these goofies, just curb these guys. Reminisce about what you had when you see what I got. You're amazing when calm down to showing you mine. You my favorite girl, and y'all wanna know why. I done changed wardrobes, I done changed your style. I'ma change your life, don't tell me it's about cloud.
Trips deep, crib, in the middle of the night. I know that you miss me cause I put it down right down, babe. Baby, I can put you on a flight. You know that a like me can change your life, oh babe. Everything you do is amazing. Ain't nobody got to go crazy. I got what you need. Everybody think you shy, but I know you're a freak, little baby. Everything you do is amazing. Ain't nobody got to go crazy. I got what you need.
You're listening to The Mix at 6 here on The Mix 88.9. That was our number 6 song, Chris Brown and Young Thug featuring Future, Lil Durk and Mulatto, the Go Crazy remix. And moving right along to our number 5 song, here is Blast featuring Ty Dolla $ign and Tyga, Chosen.
Give me the hip hop countdown. Yo.
Number 5.
Ay, when it come to you, pistol like buzz, issue with trust. Won't let no one get a piece of your love. Yeah, base it on loyalty, base it on us. I ain't the picture perfect type, but I'm making it up. You say you want a bad flip it, I can't get enough. I'm rich and long, but when I'm with you, I'm bitter as forbidden food on apple juice, can I sip on the cup? Mix it with some 1942 and I'm hitting you up. Girl, you chosen. Get up when you bust wide open. It's the ocean, I'm just imposing. That you give it to me and just me only. Yeah, girl, you chosen. Get up when you bust wide open. It's the ocean, I'm just imposing. That you give it to me and just me only.
Girl, you chosen. Sign is in the air, no, you can't bring no phones in. We walk in and they're like, what's all the commotion? No, he can't step a foot in here if we don't know him. Treat you special, girl, I hit you with the roses. Can't stand your boyfriend, he's too controlling. You get along better with me. Get up when you bust wide open.
Girl, you chosen. Get up when you bust wide open. It's the ocean, I'm just imposing. That you give it to me and just me only. Yeah, girl, you chosen. Get up when you bust wide open. It's the ocean, I'm just imposing. That you give it to me and just me only.
With her. Yeah, brand new Rollie got you frozen. Yeah. 2 more shots, got that pussy wide open. Said she wanna go another round, don't provoke him. Shorty up and down on the pole like she voting. I like when you talk that to me. This ain't nothing new, but you know how to do it to me. Turn the face down, we can make a little movie. I'm the rapper, you the groupie, got it with it in jacuzzi. She love me like Lucy. I'm a dog like Snoopy. Getting head in the sheets and you sweating out your weave. Rich. I ain't cheap when I like what I see.
Girl, you chosen. Get up when you bust wide open. It's the ocean, I'm just imposing. That you give it to me and just me only. Yeah. Girl, you chosen. Get up when you bust wide open. It's the ocean, I'm just imposing. That you give it to me and just me only.
You're listening to The Mix at 6 here on The Mix 88.9. That was our number 5 song, Blast, featuring Ty Dolla $ign and Tyga, Chosen. Now, one of my favorite end-of-year things to do is to be on the lookout for Uncle Murder's wrap-up. Now, what that is, for those who don't know, Uncle Murder, every year, he does a wrap-up where he pretty much put everything on blast, put everybody on blast, nothing and no one is safe, and I love him. I have loved the wrap-up for the past few years, and this year was no different. But as a matter of fact, those who may not know, Skills is actually the originator of the wrap-ups. So he did one also, along with Justina Valentine from Wildin' Out, the white girl with the red hair. She did one also. I got a snippet from Uncle Murder's wrap-up, and here's a snippet from his.
Smoke a blood right now and get in my zone. Academic said Freddie Gibbs got beat up by Jim Jones. Not a big fan of his, the streets don't rock with him. That be Elliot and B, not giving all of those props to him. So when he talk tough, we don't believe what he say. His father cop and his brother down with the DA. Yeah, I ain't like his reaction when Nas won the Grammy. He never lost in court cause law enforcement is his family. I know I ain't the only one that feel like he hated. Freddie album ain't deserve to be Grammy nominated. Nope.
Now the last few years, his wrap-ups have been really long, like 9-10 minutes long. This wrap up is 13 minutes long, and it's just, I love them because I'm messy. I love them because I love being in people's business. I love hearing people talk about people, but I do want it to stay where it is. All he does is give opinions, he give his opinions, and you know, some of them he taking jabs at people, some of them He just commenting on things that he sees and stuff he sees, and I'm all about that. I'm all about that. So I just hope that, you know, Freddie Gibbs don't take nothing personal, and it just stays where it should be. You know, Freddie Gibbs continue to get money, and Uncle Murder continues to give us these wrap-ups. Now, allegedly, this is supposed to be the last year he was doing them. I hope that's not the case, but we will see. And as a matter of fact, when I said Skills was the originator of it, Skills wasn't going to do one this year either. He also said this was going to be his last one, but he ended up dropping one. And I got a snippet from his, too. Here it is.
Damn, the year went by fast. That's a well-known fact. So for one last time, I'm going to run it back. So y'all pull up. I got some shit to discuss. This the Mad Skills 2021 wrap-up. First, what's something black people would never do? Run up in the Capitol. Y'all fools never cease to amaze me. I was at home watching like, bruh, these white people are crazy. But my people had me scared, cause you gotta be brain dead to put some damn glue in your head. And Biden got in and lifted our spirits, but he only got in cause of Kamala Harris. We needed a woman vice president, but the joke's on us cause we ain't seen her since. Oh, you the VP? Go figure. And thank God they banned Trump's ass from Twitter.
And lastly, but certainly not least, Justina Valentine dropped hers also, like I stated before. I do have a snippet of it. Justina is dope. This one is really good. It's 4 minutes long, so I'm not going to play the whole thing. I'm just going to play a part of it. I have the whole thing, and if you want to check it out, it is on YouTube. Like I said, it's only 3 minutes and 50 seconds, so and it goes by really fast. But she's dope. Y'all got to stop sleeping on Justina, but here's a snippet of hers.
Kim and Kanye pulled apart, said they were calling it quits. A lot of couples had to break off. Don't know what offset the beef, but I think Saweetie told Quavo take off. Just do it, get the coin, we know money rules. Lil Nas gave a new definition to bloody shoes. Montero's kicks were too hot to handle. We all got entangled in Derrick Jackson cheating scandal. A lot of rappers in the game and we see them flex, but ain't nobody like the legendary DMX. We lost a legend, the Ross reppin', he's up in heaven. Him and Biggie and Pac having a cypher session. The world cried for George Floyd, I know you heard it. Together we celebrated for Chauvin's guilty verdict.
But yeah, if you got some time, check those out. I check them out every year. I look for them. I have a good time listening to them. It's good for a laugh. It's good for reminding you of things that happened that you may have forgotten. These years come and go so fast. Stuff happens seemingly every few minutes. It's easy to forget the things that have happened this year and to imagine that all of that happened in 1 year. Like some of that stuff, you're like, I swear that happened in 2020. And they're like, nah, that was this year. That was, you know, this past year. So that's why I listen to them. And like I said, they're messy and they give me a reminder of what we left behind and reminds us of things that we may have forgotten, because this 24-hour news cycle and having your phone and your tablet and your laptop give you access to so much information. It's so much information that can be overwhelming and easy to forget things that have happened. Like, I forgot all about the Gorilla Glue Girl. I forgot all about it. And listening to them, like, oh yeah, that did happen. She did do that, you know. And the Capitol riots, that happened in 2021. Like, it was, you know, 2020 2021, you know, it was like the third day. It was like a year ago today, matter of fact, that it happened. So it was easy to forget that kind of stuff. So that's why I listen to them. So if you got a few minutes, go and check them out. Like I said, it was Uncle Murda, Skills, and Justina Valentine. They all did separate ones. They all did their separate wrap-ups. Hers is 3 minutes and 50 seconds long. Uncle Murder's is 13 minutes long. And I didn't see how long Skills was, but I haven't even listened to his all the way through, so I'm going to check out his. I always listen to Uncle Murder, and I just listened to Justine before I played it for y'all. So, you know, that's just, you know, way for me to tell y'all to go be nosy. Go be nosy and reminisce on the year that we passed. So hopefully we learn from the past so we can move forward and have a great 2022. I'm still not used to saying that. I'm still writing 2021 on stuff, and I don't know how long that goes before I stop doing that. As a matter of fact, I had to write a letter yesterday, and I'm not sure if I put 2022 or 2021. I think I put 2021. I need to go check that, because it was kind of a it was an important letter. It was an important letter, taking care of a serious situation, and I have to make sure that I wrote the right date on it, but I'm like 1,000% sure I put 2021 on there. So I gotta go fix that. So while I go check that out, let me give y'all some music to listen to. In the meantime, we're gonna get back into this countdown, we're gonna get back into this mix, we're gonna get into this number 4 song. So here's Doja Cat in The Weeknd, You Right, here on The Mix at 6 on The Mix 88.9.
Give me the hip hop
countdown.
Yeah.
Number 4.
Listening to The Mix at 6 here on The Mix 88.9. That was our number 4 song, Doja Cat and The Weeknd, You Right. And moving right along to our number 3 song, here is Drake featuring Lil Baby, Girls Want Girls.
Give me the hip hop
countdown.
Yeah. Number 3.
Whoa. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Hey. Staring at your dress cause it's see-through. Yeah, talking out that you done been through. Yeah, say that you a lesbian, girl, me too. Hey, girls want girls where I'm from. Hey, well, yeah, girls want girls where, hey, well, yeah. Girls want girls where I'm from. Yeah, yeah, girls want girls where, hey, well, girls want girls where I'm from. Hey, can I play a player, baby? I grew up with Dre and FaZe. I done seen the realest ones come and leave a crazy way. Had to take my spot, it wasn't something they just gave away. Sorry to all my fans, they might have called me on a crazy day. Thinking trying to block me on a fadeaway. I've been on the down, only vibe with a payday. Say you go that way, I guess we both go the same way. Girls want girls where I'm from. Yeah, yeah, where we both from. Hey, and you just got to Miami, need hotel rooms. Told you that they love you, but they fell through. So you shot in 42 cause you throwing on that dress cause it's see-through. Yeah, talking out of that you done been through. Yeah, texting me and say I need to see you. I don't know. I might come, I might go, I don't know. Staring at your dress cause it's see-through. Yeah, talking all the that you done been through. Yeah, say that you a lesbian, girl, me too. Hey, girls want girls where I'm from. Yeah, well, girls want girls where I'm from. Girls want girls where I'm from. Yeah, girls want girls. Hey, yeah, girls want girls where I'm
my
from.
Girl got a girlfriend. Ain't tryna be out of shape. What's the up on them curls? Then them gym don't work, get surgery. I'll pay for that, my courtesy. Can't imagine no curving me. I put in that work overly. I handle business and I got too pretty. Keep them up on fleek. They got matching beans and matching AP. Now they can really call each other twins. I'm cool with all the owners, they love me. So they gon' let us in and bring all of your peers and look better with more people. We got 1942 Casamigos, it's getting heated. They gotta follow us in the Uber, my car filled up with shooters. It be lights, camera, action when you with us, it's a movie. I don't try my coupe to house parties, I'm tryna leave with two of them. Yeah. Don't nobody know that we do. She like eating, I'm like me too. I can't wait to get out work to go and see you. Please bring your girlfriend along with you. Y'all been on my mind too much, like what the f- is wrong with me? She said it's something about the way your girl just makes her feel. Whatever you been dreaming about, I swear to make it real. Just run around the town with me, then come lay down.
I don't know. I might come, I might go,
I don't know.
I might come, I might go, I don't know. Staring at your dress cause it's see-through. Yeah, talking out of the that you done been through. Yeah, say that you a lesbian, girl, me too. Hey, girls want girls where I'm from. Hey, well, yeah, girls want girls where, yeah, well, yeah. Girls want girls where I'm from. Yeah, yeah, girls want girls where, yeah, well, girls want girls where I'm from. But I know you wanna roll with the gang, and I know you want the finest of things. Asking me about settling down, cause you know that things are going my way.
And you're listening to The Mix at 6 here on The Mix 88.9. That was our number 3 song, Drake featuring Lil Baby, Girls Want Girls. And to give an update to my little mini crisis I had before this last music break, I absolutely put the wrong date on the letter. I absolutely put 2021 instead of 2022. I wonder how long it's going to take for me to reprogram and, well, not reprogram, but just update my software so I say 2022 instead of 2021. I guess time will tell. Now, this last section, this last part, this last segment is a subject that's near and dear to my heart. It's near and dear to me because I am a proud member. And what am I talking about? I'm talking about vasectomies. I'm talking about the process in which I can no longer bear fruit, and I couldn't be happier. Best decision I ever made. But some people don't think that. Some people think that getting vasectomies makes you less of a man. One of these individuals is Chadwick Moore. Who is Chadwick Moore, you might be asking? Well, he's the editor-in-chief of Outspoken. He was on Fox News on the Tucker Carlson show, and they were discussing vasectomies. Now, let's see what this individual had to say, because I'm sure that it was thought-provoking, I'm sure that it was coherent, I'm sure that it was educational, and I'm sure that we will all learn something. Here's what he had to say.
I mean, is this an act of love, or is this really just about consequence-free sex?
I mean, why stop at the vasectomy? I think you just lob the whole thing off and become trans. That's what you should do if you really love your wife and want to show her what a supporter of womanhood you are and of the female cause. I mean, consequence-free sex, it is what drives the left. It's their religion. They believe in population control. They want fewer people on the planet. So I wonder how, if you were to take this to parts of the world where the population is exploding, like in, I don't know, sub-Saharan Africa, or Central America, I wonder how those men would react to being told that they should have a vasectomy to show how much they love their women. And I hope that these men get, you know, a free box set of Harry Potter when they go in for their snip and some Soylent and whatever else they like to do with their free time. Fine, if that's what you want to do, go for it. It does make you less of a man. I'm sorry.
Okay. I don't even know where to... Okay, I got it. I stated that all opinions are valid. All opinions are welcome. All opinions are valued. And I mean that. It's his opinion. And he's entitled to his opinion. And there's nothing wrong with his opinion if that's how he feels. I am just going to tell you about me. My personal experience getting a vasectomy. Now, I don't think that makes me less of a man. I don't think that makes me less of a provider. It doesn't make me less of anything. I am a proud father. There's nothing I love more than being a girl dad. I have two beautiful daughters, and I have a son that is a terror. But I wouldn't trade him for anything. I wouldn't trade any of them for anything. My oldest daughter, as those who know, is a competitive cheerleader. My middle daughter is a gymnast. And my son is a child terrorist. Those are their jobs, and that's what they do on a daily basis. And they're very good at their jobs. But there's nothing that I love more than having my children. Than being around my babies, have them running back and forth by my room and playing games. As a matter of fact, my oldest daughter is waiting for me to finish with the show right now so we can play Connect Four. We played the other night and I won. We played a best of five series and I do not hold back on them. But we have fun together. But a few years ago, I did make the decision to get a vasectomy. And the reason being is that it was the best decision for me. It was the best decision for us. I didn't want any more children. Not saying that those who do are, you know, a certain way or it that doesn't matter. It was just for me, I was done having children. You know, I had girls, I have boys. I mean, what am I trying to prove? I have children that are going to do wonderful things in the world. I went and got a vasectomy through the VA. It was a different experience. I will say that it was a quick experience. It took them longer to set everything up and to get me prepped and ready than it did for the actual procedure. I was awake the whole time. They numbed me and they went ahead and snipped. I felt a lot of pressure for about a second. That happened twice and then they tied up and burned and whatever they did and put everything back together. And that happened on a Friday and I was good to go on Sunday. I was walking around good to go on Sunday. So, but that was just my experience. Now, I'm not sure why he decided to make this a political thing or why he decided to make it take a political stance on it. Like they want you to have vasectomies. Nobody told me that. It's just a decision that I made. So, I don't watch the news. So maybe they are telling everybody to get vasectomies. I don't know. I don't watch the news. So if I'm wrong, if they are pushing vasectomies on people, then let me know, because you know it's a personal decision. Like I stated earlier, do what's best for you, do what's best for your situation, do what's best for your family. If what's best for your situation is to have a bunch of kids, then go be happy, go have a bunch of kids, go do whatever you have to do or whatever you need to do to ensure your happiness. But for me personally, I was done. I had nothing left to prove. I had nothing left to do. Same sensations, no kids. I would never call my children or call children in general consequences of sex, because that's not what they are. My babies are blessings, and I am lucky to be their father, watching them do great things, and I am just blessed with wonderful children, and I don't look down on anyone who decides to have a bunch of children, as long as you can take care of them. If you can take care of them and your family and your children are happy, that's all that matters. That's all that matters. It shouldn't be a political thing. We shouldn't make this into a political thing. It has nothing to do with your politics or who you vote for. It's simply what's best for you. So, Mr. Chadwick, I would respectfully disagree with you, but it's okay. We can agree to disagree. We don't have to have the same stance on things. Your view is your view, and I respect it. I'm not a hypocrite. I did say that all opinions are valid, and your opinion is a valid opinion. It's just that. It's an opinion. It's an opinion. So everyone should do what works for them. And if getting a vasectomy is what works for you, it doesn't make you less of a man. It doesn't make you less of a provider. It doesn't make you less of a father. It doesn't make you less of anything. It's just a decision that you make that is best for you. But make sure it's one that you want to make, because they're going to grill you when you go in to get your vasectomy. They're going to ask you a bunch of questions. Some of them get pretty dark. They're like, well, what if one of your children die? And, you know, they'll ask you stuff like that. Like, don't you want to, you know, have kids in case one of them dies? I'm like, whoa. I'm like, no, I'm okay. But I have two. They'll ask you. If you don't have any kids, they really try to steer you away from it. But I've had children. I've had that experience. I'm still going through that experience. And I wouldn't trade it for anything. So do what works for you. Do what's best for you. Do what makes you happy. Don't worry about what somebody else got to say. It don't make you less of nothing. It makes you for making a decision that works for you and works for your family. So, sir, I respectfully disagree. But that's okay. We can agree to disagree on this show, because that's what we do. It's all love. But let's go ahead and hop back into this countdown. How about that? Enough about talking about snipping balls. So let's hop into this number two song. Here is Doja Cat featuring SZA, Kiss Me More, here on The Mix at 6 on The Mix 88.9.
Give me the hip-hop
countdown. Jump. Number two.
Oh, yeah.
And you're listening to The Mix of Six here on The Mix 88.9. That was our number two song, Doja Cat featuring SZA, Kiss Me More. Now, before I get into my number one song, let me take a second, as always, to thank some of our sponsors.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
So, who's trying to spend 12 hours in a salon? Not me, and not you either. Nobody wants to spend their whole day like that. Yo, pull up and get slayed by the V. I'm trying to put you on. Vanquish Beauty Studio is the move. 2130 Ward's Road in Lynchburg. They provide confidence and sass, so it accommodates the swag you already have. Their talented artists specialize in color, cut, healthy, and diverse textures of hair. They're a three-time award-winning salon right in Lynchburg. Vanquish Beauty Studio. They'll turn your hair ideas into a reality without spending the whole day in the salon. So book your appointment now. Go online to vanquishbeautystudio.com or call 434-239-HAIR. That's 434-239-4247. Experience a professional salon, impeccable style, ambiance, and sophistication all in one place. Vanquish Beauty Studio. Pull up and get slayed by the V.
How do you make financial decisions? Are you retiring soon or wondering how much life insurance is enough? Your family and financial future is the most important thing, and having answers to these questions are mandatory. Bold Financial Strategies is a successful financial team that can help you answer these questions while achieving your goals. Bold Financial Strategies offers a suite of services that range from retirement plans and college savings to homeowners insurance policies, as well as estate planning and life insurance protection. We pride ourselves on making the process simple and understandable for all of our clients. Take control of your financial future and visit our website at boldfinancialstrategies.com or give us a call at 434-215-0695. The team of advisors includes owner Damon Bolden, Garnett Spanky McDaniel, Randy Calloway, and Devin Bowling. We are located at 3712 Old Forest Road, Suite 400, Lynchburg, Virginia. Oh, and we also make ourselves available for online and virtual appointments. Bold Financial Strategies. We help all of our clients plan and make smarter financial decisions, and we would love to start with yours.
It's time for The Mix at 6. Counting down the top hip-hop and R&B songs in the country. The Mix 88.9. Lynchburg's number one station for hip-hop and R&B. Soul and reggae.
Give me the hip-hop countdown.
Yeah. This is the number one song.
Number one. Yeah. DJ gon' play it.
Her best work on her knees.
sexy for this cash, too sexy for this surf, too sexy for these pills, I'm too sexy for this. I get cash wherever I fly, got on me. Money, cars, and all the jewelry, make a sexy. I get cash wherever I fly, got on me. Yeah, whoa, whoa, whoa. I'm too sexy for this surf, too sexy for your girl, too sexy for this world, too sexy for this ice, too sexy for that jack, yeah, yeah. I'm too sexy for this chain, too sexy for your game, too sexy for this fame, yeah, yeah. I'm too sexy for the trap, too sexy for that cap, too sexy for that jack, yeah, yeah.
Too sexy to count, Fitty, my neck, Bugatti, red diamond, spaghetti, this paper, I shred it, I swindle, no sweating, I saw you begging, goddamn you pity, I ain't done spinning, no pin pinch, I spin it, bags in that, my man ain't gon' steal it, on the bag for maybe y'all wish they was rich. A Green Gators, they look like a switch. Giorgio, I spit 26 licks. Too sexy, my neck, Bugattis. Caress me, I'll let you today ski. I've been kicking, might need a prosthetic. I pray to the chopper under my pillow, too fairy.
You're listening to The Mix at 6 here on The Mix 88.9. That was our number one song, Drake featuring Future and Young Thug, Way Too Sexy. Earlier, I was talking about wrap-ups. I was talking about how I enjoyed, I can't talk all of a sudden, how I enjoyed listening to wrap-ups. Well, it's not time for me to do my own wrap-up. I do mine a little different. I don't talk about people or tell y'all a bunch of stuff that already happened. My wrap-up consists of me simply saying thank you. My wrap-up consists of me giving you your flowers while you're here because you supported me. You could have been anywhere else for this last hour, and you chose to hang out with me, and I appreciate it. But if you happen to be new here, all I ask is that, well, for one, I hope you had a good time. I hope you enjoyed yourself. I hope that I provided at least one laugh, one smile, a couple of giggles. That's the goal, why you got to relax and have me on in the background while this voice envelops you. That's what it does. It envelops you. It holds you. It hugs you and lets you know everything's going to be okay. But if you liked what you heard, let someone else know. And even if you didn't like it, tell an enemy. If you like it, tell a friend. If you didn't like it, tell an enemy. Let them know to download the app. Let them know to go to their Google Play, Apple App Store, search The Mix 88.9, and let them know that I am here Monday through Friday, 6 p.m. to 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. They can also follow us on social media, Facebook and Instagram, The Mix 88.9, and on Twitter, The Mix 8991. They can also listen via the internet, themixradio.online. That's themixradio.online. We are here 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. We got old school, new school, reggae. We got everything you need, inspirational on Sundays. We got you covered in all aspects. And you don't have anywhere to go after this show because following me, as always, DJ Kid New in the recovery room, he got you covered because I am a lot and you're going to need somewhere to recover. And that's where he has you covered. It's a lot of covering, but he got you. So DJ Kid New, the talk of New York, DJ Kid New in the recovery room. If you've liked me and you want to follow me personally, you can. Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Twitch, Discord. I am on all of them at Kalel Creed DB. That's KalelCreedDB. If you've missed any part of the show, or you want to catch up on this show or past episodes, go over to my YouTube page, The Fortress of Awesometude. That's AwesomeTude. Go to my playlist, look for Vibe Club, and they are all there. This also goes live on my Facebook page, my Kalel Creed DB Facebook page, as soon as I'm done here at 7 o'clock. It goes live on Facebook and over on YouTube. But that's going to wrap it up for me today, y'all. I appreciate you. I will be here tomorrow at 6 o'clock for The Mix at 6. Y'all have a great evening. Take care of yourself.